Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Cosmic Closet Podcast. I am your host, Blaine. It's just me today. Jacob is studying for an exam. But we are going to be looking at an interesting project called Project Azorian. Project Azorian was an interesting and kind of an older project. The backstory is that in 1968, a K-129 Soviet submarine sank, and on this submarine was three SSN-4 nuclear-armed ballistic missiles. And it fell to the bottom of the Pacific Ocean, and the mission was to see what was on this submarine. However, the Soviets wanted to retrieve it. So for some time, the Soviets searched the Soviet Navy, but they never found it. They could never locate it. But then the U.S. discovered it about 1,500 miles northwest of Hawaii and about 16,500 feet below the sea. However, once it was located, it's not like they could just go down and just scoop it up. This was also the 70s. The technology wasn't really there yet. But also, the submarine itself weighed 1,750 tons, and it was 132 feet long. The mission had to be done covertly in order to make sure that the Soviets and the American public did not find out about the mission. So how do you get this submarine off the bottom of the ocean floor? Well, that's where Project Azorian was born. It was one of the most complex, expensive, and secretive intelligence operations of the Cold War, and cost $800 million at the time, but in today's terms, that would be about $4 billion. And it started with a man called Howard Hughes, who was contracted to construct the Hughes-Glomar Explorer, which would serve as a decoy ship, essentially, but it was disguised as a sea drill ship. So when on the surface, it looks like they were just going to be drilling for oil, but secretly they were reaching down to pick up this lost Soviet sub. Contrary to belief, Howard Hughes had no involvement in the project. All he did was lend his name to the ship. After the time of its completion in 1972, the ship was 63,000 tons and 619 feet long, and it was named the Hughes-Glomar Explorer. Now, Howard Hughes had a history with the U.S. government. He had already been contracted on multiple military projects, including U.S. military weapons, aircraft, and satellites. So he agreed to lend his name. The ship itself was built in the Sun Shipbuilding Yard in Philadelphia. After its completion, the mission was designed. Essentially, a capture vehicle was put on the ship, which was a large mechanical claw. And the capture vehicle was designed to be lowered all the way down to the ocean floor, where it would grab the submarine and then lift it back up to the ship. However, it's hard to imagine just how hard it would be to grab a submarine 16,000 feet below the sea level. So on the CIA's website, this is on the CIA's website, they said, imagine standing atop the Empire State Building with an 8-foot wide grappling hook on a 1-inch diameter steel rope. Your task is to lower the hook to the street below, snag a compact car full of gold, and lift the car back to the top of the building, the Empire State Building. On top of that, the job has to be done without anyone noticing. That essentially describes what the CIA did in Project Azorian. Not an easy task, especially when you put it like that. The Glomar sailed from Long Beach, California, and it arrived at the recovery site on July 4th, 1974, Independence Day. And for there, it conducted the salvage operation for over a month, in total secrecy. And there were Soviet ships that were curious about the mission. And the CIA admits that many small things went wrong. But during the lift, the biggest mistake was that a third of the submarine broke off on its way up. It broke apart and plunged back down to the bottom of the floor, ocean floor. However, they still pulled up the portion remaining in the claw. In the portion that was recovered, the military found the bodies of the six Soviet submariners, and in a show of goodwill, they gave them a formal military burial at sea. The director of the CIA at the time, Robert Gates, presented the film to the Russian president at the time, Boris Yeltsin, in 1992. Almost immediately after this was recovered, the military started to think about another way to get the rest of the portions of the submarine. However, there was the media. The media had picked up on this secret operation after a series of break-ins revealed documents that tied Howard Hughes to the CIA and other military contracts. William Colby, the CIA director at the time, informed the media not to disclose the project yet, as they still wanted to recover the portions, and if they leaked it, the Soviets would find out about it. For a while, the media did agree, and they cooperated, but on February 18, 1975, the Los Angeles Times published a story that connected the robbery, Hughes, the CIA, and the submarine recovery mission. Investigative reporter Jack Anderson even went on national television, broke the story to a live audience. After the media picked up on the story, so did the Soviets, and the media flooded to Long Beach, where the Glomar was in port, preparing for a second recovery mission. The Soviets, however, dispatched a ship to monitor and guard the recovery site. And with the Glomar exposed, the White House canceled the future missions, and the rest of the Soviet sub was never recovered by the Americans.
We were on the verge of greatness. We were this close.
Despite losing the other two portions, the CIA still believes that this is one of the greatest intelligence missions during the Cold War and possibly in history. It was a successful project, and the recovered section had two nuclear torpedoes. This whole entire salvage operation was recorded by a CIA documentary film crew, but the film is still classified to this day, and we do not know when it will be released. The only part of the film that the public has seen is the part with the burial at sea, which was given to Russia in 1992. However, there are several conspiracy theories that surround Project Azorian, naturally. One of them is that the whole operation was a cover-up for a cover-up, and that they actually tapped undersea communication cables. Another one believes that a missile silo was created in the ocean, and another one believes that a surveillance system was developed to monitor ship and submarine movements in the ocean. Nevertheless, Project Azorian was a huge success. It was a heist of Soviet military technology, and we learned much about their nuclear torpedo capabilities. To this day, it is unknown entirely what the project salvaged until that film is released, but it is an interesting project, and much like Project Stargate, I enjoy looking into these and learning about them, and there's a plethora of government projects that are no longer secret. I mean, every day, stuff is getting declassified, and it's becoming public, and it's interesting to see the lengths that world governments go to gain a competitive edge. And this is just one of those feats where the American government constructed a decoy drill ship to steal Soviet military technology 16,000 feet below the sea. That is absolutely incredible. So please, I know this is a short episode, just comment what you think about this. There's plenty of information online. I got most of these facts right off of the CIA website. It's all declassified. And it's just amazing. And in combination with the nuclear missiles, they found documents and Soviet equipment. So although the project cost $4 billion in today's money, the value of the technology that they seized, the information that they gathered, and what they found out is way more than $4 billion. You can't put a price tag on knowing what your enemies have, knowing what they're talking about, where they're going. And so, I'm enjoying this little series, looking into military projects, but of course we will keep up the paranormal. We have guests coming on to talk about Bigfoot, aliens, ghosts, everything. And Jacob will be on soon, And sorry about this little hiatus. We were back in college now, so we're back in the groove. Make sure to like, share, and comment down below, please. What do you think about this project? What project should we cover? What do you want us to look at? And we will see you on the next episode of the Cosmic Closet Podcast. Thank you for listening.